Strap yourself in. It's time for Tommy Paradise and DJ with The Run-In. The Run-In Podcast.
Hey, hey, what do you say? Episode 152. My wife heard me saying, or I'm sorry, 153. Episode 153. My wife heard me say that the other day. She's like, I can't believe you guys have been doing this for 153 episodes. My name is Tommy Paradise.
It's showtime, folks. It's your boy DJ. And feliz cumpleaños to my girl Athena. She just went around the sun one more time, and I'm happy that she did.
Nice. Congratulations. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Sad we did not get to meet when I was out there in for WrestleMania, but that's all right. That's all right. Yeah, something to do later.
She's a few miles away for that particular event.
Also, before we get going here, I want to just say thoughts with the people in Lewiston, Maine, a little bit north here. Terrible events going on there last night. And the guy, apparently, they kept calling him like the suspect in question or the person of question this morning on the radio. And it's like, no, it's, you have pictures of this guy with a gun, and it's this motherfucker did it. But thoughts and prayers or whatever. Good mojo. Hopefully they catch this motherfucker soon. So and hopefully one day this country can get their shit together and do something about the gun laws here. But anyway, that's a whole nother podcast for another time. But I just wanted to start the show by acknowledging what happened in Lewiston, Maine. I do have some news for you. As you guys know, this show is always brought to you by Figure Collections. Hit up shop.figurecollections.com and make sure you got that shit bookmarked on Halloween, because on Halloween Tuesday, we have James Mitchell Bone Crusher going up for pre-order. I think he fits in the bone crushing line perfectly. Get to that website, pre-order that, and of course get your Blue Meanie Brian Clark. And there is some more coming along the way. Sonny Ono in production, of course, with Ultimo Dragon 2-pack. And Macho Man Randy Savage in production. Nice. And a whole lot, Dwayne Gill, and a whole lot more. So Jack is constantly working. I've mentioned it before on here that I'm talking with Jack every day, helping him out. I'm kind of an unofficial Figure Collections employee. But I'm still what's the word I'm looking for? I'm still not neutral, but like I'm still fair when I give my assessment of things. I tell them straight up, man. I'll be like, that looks like caca. Or that head sculpt looks like caca. This looks like shit.
Well, you kind of have to. Right?
That's what he's
looking
for.
Because when it goes out to the public, you know, what they're going to help to be a yes man, and then it goes out to the real people out there that are actually putting their hard-earned money down.
Yeah, absolutely.
And they don't like it, you know. Absolutely. You know, so no,
we don't want no rush collectible bullshit.
No, so yeah, nothing wrong with that.
All right,
I'm pretty sure he appreciates it.
Absolutely, absolutely. Halloween, speaking of, about a week away, I still have no fucking idea what we're doing except for the fact that we are going trick or treating on Halloween night. Aside from that, I have no idea. Like, I think I mentioned it last week. We have a Halloween party on the 4th that we're invited to. I have no idea if we're going to it because the kids got baseball playoffs, and man, I was so excited. We're like, all right, baseball's almost over. Things will free up a little bit. And then he starts talking with some of his baseball buddies, and one of the coaches shoots me a text and says, hey, is Logan interested in doing, flag football with the baseball boys from December to February? It's Sunday mornings. So I asked him, maybe I'm a glutton, I don't know. I asked him and I said, hey bro, do you want to do this? And he's of course said yes. So baseball ends, we'll have like a month with no with just hockey, and then we go to hockey and flag football and baseball practice in January.
So, why don't you just sign up to be offensive coordinator? Yeah. What the hell, you know?
Nah, dude,
I'm the West Coast offense, and
my coaching days are over. 100%, my coaching days are over. I will do other volunteer stuff, but my coaching days are over. I was just telling you, I got an email about a tournament.
Right. Oh, yeah.
That we're going to for hockey on Thanksgiving weekend.
And I'm like, you guys about to have Thanksgiving dinner in the car.
They call me Team Mom Tom because, like, I will help coordinate tournaments and team dinners and things like that. I'll do the music. But that's about where I draw the line. I have a great relationship with all the kids on both of his teams, but it's where I draw the line, man, where I just I don't want to do anything more than coaching. Coaching is a headache. Shout out to all you coaches out there because it is a lot of fucking work,
man.
But yeah. What about you guys got plans? You guys got plans for Halloween?
Man, I'm with you where you know how you like my shoot job. I have to be there early in the morning on the first.
Yeah.
For November 1st, so that like this is, I really feel like me and MJ were talking about this. Halloween should be something like Easter and Thanksgiving. It should be the last Friday or Saturday of October.
I agree 100%.
Just leave it there, because it's like the way this makes me feel is that I need to do something like I would rather have done something this coming Friday or you know, that Friday or Saturday before.
Right.
And then just let the 31st come and then it be a regular day, you know? So even the kids, like, I mean, you know, the young kids, you're going to have the young kids out there, you know, well, at least the sun's going down earlier now.
Right.
at this time of year. So you have that, but yeah, I don't like it. That this is a day that's just for fun and it moves all around. Just, you know, do like you did the other holidays and just make it pick a day and not the number, but the actual like Friday or Saturday and leave it. And leave
it there. I agree. It's always best when it's on a Saturday. Like I remember a couple years ago, it was on a Saturday and we did our thing where we have everybody. We've talked about this. We're like,
yeah.
We have a great, great, great neighborhood for trick or treating.
Right.
And, when it was on a Saturday, it was like the kids all hung out afterwards. And then we went and did like a fire in the backyard and parents hung out and just had a blast. Like, it was all good stuff. I wish
yep.
we could just have like
we got,
the Saturday.
We got to like wait said, like 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, the last Saturday.
That way again.
The last Saturday of October should be Halloween when we go trick-or-treating and do all that stuff. I only got a couple more years left of this, maybe one or two. So we'll see. We'll see.
Nah, you'll probably still do some party stuff.
Yeah.
Rather than the trick-or-treating.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean for the
years
kid.
Past trick-or-treating, I still, when I can do something on Halloween.
It is crazy. Chris Matthews, we are live, by the way, on Facebook or and Twitch and our YouTube. Fabulous Disaster says, hey, yo. But Chris Matthews says there was a push to move it from the 31st a few years ago, but there was so much backlash at the idea of moving it. Yeah, it's crazy.
The people
man.
Be
it's...
mad for a minute.
Yeah, they'll get over
after
it.
That
right?
Second year that they, the second year, you'll it'll all die down.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, they'll be like, wait, it's on the Saturday again.
People hate change. That's what it comes down to.
That's all it is.
People hate change. But so you have no idea what you're going for as a costume or anything like that.
No. Same all here. I know is that I want to see that Martin Scorsese movie. With Leo about nope. Native America. It's like basically a mafia movie, but with Native Americans. That's basically what it is.
It comes out on Halloween.
No, it just came out. But somewhere, I'm just saying somewhere in there, I want to see that movie.
Ah,
We'll probably think of something, but right now I just don't know. I'm not sure at the moment.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll figure something out too. So stay tuned for that. The kid's at a point too where he's like super cheap Halloween costume where like all he has to do, he bought a mask and a knife and that's it. And I'm like all on board with that. We don't need these big elaborate things. So
one of his buddies, his hockey gear.
He said he wanted to be a blind ref originally where he just wore sunglasses
hilarious.
And a ref shirt.
Yep.
But.
Or umpire, that would be, yes.
Yeah, exactly. So, all right. Enough chit chat. Let's get in the ring. In the Ring is brought to you by SeatGeek. I'm still contemplating going to AEW Collision this week, especially after they announced MJF and Omega as the main event. That's going to be a banger. We'll talk about that in a minute.
I got to know if you do get free Taco Bell for doing that.
Yeah, Fabulous Disaster says, I'm going to be a taco with my wife and kid. Maybe we can score some free Taco Bell. I hope you do. I hope you do.
Let me know. I might do it. those Doritos Locos? Those are...
SeatGeek is where you go to grab your concert tickets. I know a lot of bands are announcing concerts this year. Blink 182, or for next year, I should say, Blink 182, Green Day. They're mentioning tours. Bad Bunny. You can get your tickets at SeatGeek.com. Use the code RUNINPOD to save $20 on your first order. Solid episode of Raw here. I feel like Raw's hitting its stride. Still has a little bit of that feel where it's like every episode is the same episode every week.
Get rid of the promo at the beginning. Yeah. That sets up the main event. Yep. Get rid of it.
But I feel like we're getting some new faces on there. It seems like Bronson Reed. We saw Indy Hartwell this week. There's a few others. That, you know, it wasn't the usual just Judgment Day for four segments. And then, we saw Chad Gable and Otis together. The New Day was on there. Some faces we haven't seen in a while. Johnny Gargano and Giovanni Vinci. Logan Paul mixing returned. Yeah, definitely mixing it up. And
you got the roster and you got 3 hours.
Mix exactly. Tozawa was on the show. Like, yep. It's good. And I think that Jey Uso and Damian Priest. I love Tozawa. That Damian Priest and Jey Uso main event, main event was solid. Solid. Yeah.
And he's so over. Over. Him and like, I don't think like Cody could, you know, I don't know. Like Cody could, I don't know what he could do to not be over, but. Like, I mean, his, you know, everybody's still all in on the entrance and everything. Like, so,
yeah.
You know, and then you got, you know, on another show, of course, but LA Knight, who's also in the stratosphere. So you got some wrestlers here that the people are digging.
Yeah, we're getting Roman Reigns versus LA Knight at Crown Jewel next week. I don't know if this is a good idea or a bad idea, to be honest with you. I don't know. Not that wins and losses matter a whole lot here, but you got to have LA Knight. He's obviously, I don't think he's going to win. No. I will stand by my statement that Roman Reigns will be world champion until WrestleMania 40, but LA Knight is so over. You have to be very careful here to not damage what he's got going on. I don't think a loss necessarily does that. Maybe you have, you know, Heyman cheat or Roman Reigns cheat. Somehow, maybe it's a dirty win, or maybe LA Knight gets the win by disqualification or count out or something like that and doesn't win the title. Right. They've done this before where last year it was Logan Paul and Roman. And I don't think Logan Paul was damaged at all coming out of
Mm-mm,
it.
Not at all. No, like you said, and this is like when people, they're always talking about, well, Roman, like, you know, and then he always cheats and. I'm like, well, okay, he's the heel.
He's a heel. So, he's supposed to.
So you know, that's kind of the thing there.
Yeah.
And two, like you're just pointed out, like when he does, like, they're not catching on that when he does that, the guy's not buried for losing the match. You know, you lost a match to a guy who might win via DQ.
Yeah.
You're talking about a guy that's had the title for 1,000-some days now, so. And you lost, but he had to cheat to beat you. So you're not, that's not going to bury you. And that keeps everybody, you know, you don't get buried down to the bottom of the roster for losing to the champ, you know?
Right.
So, you know, I'm all like, you know, I think that's what's going to happen. They're going to put they're going to put on a good show. Even though we've been saying like, this is like the biggest, like, it's like a big house show. Like that's, you know, just kind of fun for everybody. Watch, but now we've seen a couple of title changes here at the Jewel.
Yeah, absolutely. The rest of the matches as of right now, we got Seth Rollins and Drew McIntyre for the World Heavyweight Championship. That's going to be a banger. I mean, we'll get into our picks and more in depth into these next week, but I would not be upset if Drew McIntyre won. Rhea Ripley, Nia Jax, Shayna Baszler, Zoe Stark, and Raquel Gonzalez, a fatal five-way for the women's championship. Rey Mysterio and Logan Paul for the U.S. title, and then Cody Rhodes and Damian Priest. So five matches so far, and all five of them sound like bangers on paper, at least. As much as I'm not a Rey Mysterio fan, I still think he can go. I still think that's going to be a great, great match so far. So that is next November 4th. That's next Saturday. Yep. I'll have to figure out how I'm watching that and when I'm watching that. Then switching gears over to AEW. Man. I got a lot to say about what happened on AEW last night. But again, I feel like they put together a solid show. There was some peaks and valleys in it. But, man, the Robinson and MJF match was a fun performance. Sure. We got to see the Dynamite debut of Okada. Yep. All in all, a decent show. But, man, Tony Khan, just keep your mouth shut. This big build, I don't want to say it was a big build. I think it was mentioned like twice, but it was still like Tony Khan's had got a surprise for Sting.
Oh, it was all week. If you count social media, like, it was
I saw it on social media, and I think they mentioned it on Collision. And it obviously is Ric Flair. I mean, I got a couple opinions on this. First of all, I don't need Ric Flair. As much as I love Ric Flair, you guys watching can see, hey, that's a Ric Flair jersey, Ric Flair print, Ric Flair signed belt, whole Ric Flair wall over here. Like, Flair is my guy, my all-time favorite, right?
Right.
I don't need Ric Flair on my TV in 2023. I don't. I just don't need it. And I don't think Sting needs a six-month send-off. As a Sting fan, I get why they're doing this. I get, okay, let's bring Flair in to
his greatest rival.
Yeah, his greatest rival ever. Like, I get the significance of that and everything. But do we really need Ric Flair on TV for 6 months in 2023/2024? And does Sting...
Is he going to be out there the whole 6 months?
He said he was going on this ride with Sting. So to me, that means
I guess
he's going to be out there with him, right? In his corner. I don't fucking know. But I don't
know. I wonder if Rick said that off script and then
and that's not what's gonna happen. Like, he came out last night and then
him saying, oh, this ain't gonna be no one night thing, and I'm gonna make sure of it because I'm gonna go out here on the mic and put myself in this storyline for 6 months. I'm creating theories here.
TK really needs to just be like a silent promoter behind the scenes. He doesn't need to make himself a character. He doesn't need to be on TV. I'm fine with him coming out at the end of shows, thanking everybody. Like, that's fine if he wants to do that. But like, you building up these big surprises and then have it be, a 72-year-old man coming out. That's not a surprise.
Triple H did some Suge Knight stuff and went on TV. And if you don't want your promoter all up in your promos, come to WWE.
You need eyes on your product. Is Ric Flair in 2023 getting new eyes on your product? I don't think so.
You also had RVD in a tag match.
Right. And you don't need to be out there every week saying you got a different surprise or a different announcement. Let your product do the talking for you. Right?
Ideally. Yeah. Ideally, you want them to. Here we go. The TK stuff is coming in.
Yeah. You better pack a lot of coke.
Oh boy.
Tony is like, Fire Marshal Bill, let me show you something. But yeah, like, so let me ask you this: Does Sting need a 6 month send off? Because his last match isn't until March, and I feel like they're pumping his tires, tickling his balls every week now. It's been 1 week since he made the announcement. We're one for one with them doing something stupid special for his send off.
Well, okay. So the way I kind of look at it is, you do have, you had other wrestlers that did the whole thing of, oh, the next time I lose a match, that's when I retire. And that's the way that they did, like, kind of a lengthy send off. Like, this time they're kind of saying, oh, the match is going to be, because, you know, Sting ain't going to wrestle every week. So they're going, the last match we're going to point to, it's going to be right there. Okay. Mm. But we're not going to do the whole, I think I'm trying to think of, because there's a couple of guys who even in AEW that just recently,
I mean Danielson, Brian Danielson's kind of doing that. He's like, 2024 is going to be my last year.
Well, I mean, the whole I'm gonna this last push, I'm gonna have all these matches, and the next time I lose, that's when I retire, kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not unusual, it's just that we know the date. Like, so, yeah. So other wrestlers, we didn't quite know the date. Because even if you remember that match before Ric Flair had the match with Shawn Michaels, Ric Flair was having, right. He was almost wrestling every week. And then finally he challenges Michaels at WrestleMania. So, mm-hmm. So it's kind of like that. Like, it's kind of, that's kind of what they're doing. But as we've talked about before, their presentation, you know, they usually have some really good ideas that could be really good on AEW, and then the presentation just doesn't hit at the last second. I think this is probably one of those times.
You're not going to like this comment that I'm about to put up on the screen from our boy to call up, but hell no, let him go home already. I agree, man. I feel like that match with Triple H at Mania should have been Sting's last match.
And that's what he said was going to be he thought it was going to be his last match. So,
or, you know, I still wish, man, we got Sting and Undertaker as his last match, as both of their last matches, honestly. Like, that would have been phenomenal for both of them.
Yep. But, and all the, still did all the run-ins and everything. That would have been,
I just feel like this is like a decent episode of AEW Dynamite again, right? But all I saw on social media was, and I know social media is not the end all be all, and wrestling Twitter is toxic and all that stuff, but it's like, all I saw was Ric Flair's back, and it's like, nobody talked about MJF and Juice Robinson having a great match. Like,
no,
it was, and this is what I feel like happens, is there's so much buildup with these Tony Khan announcements, and then they fall flat, and it's just like, well, now, because he's such an idiot that everybody just wants to laugh at him afterwards, and it produces more negativity for your product. It's like, those, him making those announcements is not helping. It's not helping anything.
I think he saw in the past, like, maybe the first, like, 3-4 times he said Tony Khan is making an announcement, that guy,
right,
that, like, moved the needle. And so now he has in his mind that, okay, that's a needle mover for me to say I have an announcement.
Right.
Whereas now, like, after you've had some, once your announcements fall flat, then, or you let it leak, like, if you, you know, when you're leaking, like, we knew about the ROH thing a week before he came on TV and said it.
Right.
So, for example, you know, so once you start doing that, then you're, people are, again, what, you're not creating an urgency to want to watch the show.
Right. No, you're absolutely right. Switching gears again. Halloween Havoc week one started this week. I did not watch it. I just, again, there's so much wrestling on, like, it's hard to keep up. Yep. But you have on here that Becky and, I don't even know how to say this girl's last, or this girl's name, Valkyra.
Yeah.
Nailed it. Yes.
Yeah.
They had a solid match. I mean, we've said it 1,000 times on here the last 6 months or so, that the new NXT has just been killing it.
Tell me
why I should go watch this.
Well, first, for NXT, if you're still one of these folks that, oh, I haven't watched since they did the Nickelodeon-looking logo, you're missing out. Like, I'll just say that. Like, it is pretty much back to what they were doing with Black and Gold. It just doesn't have the dingy dark arena look anymore. That's the only difference. Everything else is back to where it was. With solid wrestling matches, people, you're seeing these wrestlers grow up in front of your eyes, just like we saw with Black and Gold. You're missing it. I'm going to just say it flat out. You're missing it. You're, get the thought out of your mind that they changed the logo for a second. Like, just, it's back to where it was. Yeah, this main event match, but like speaking of, so you had Valkyra. She made a name for herself in this match. Like, there's no question. This was her coming out match. And this is probably why they put the title on Becky, because she can push her. They knew that they can push her to have this type of a match.
Mm-hmm.
So you see everything kind of, you know, sometimes you got to see what the, before you start, you know, throwing rocks at whatever idea. And then you see the difference with, okay, the presentation was there for this. So it's like, here you have this young lady that we probably didn't even see coming, have this big moment with Becky, and then go to just to give you an example of AEW, like this should have been like that whole promo should have been a big moment, but
yeah,
it kind of wasn't, right?
Yep.
Then you had Brian Pillman Jr., Alexis King. Alexis King had his match, and he had you could tell his outfit is an homage to his dad and the crazy, like with the when his dad was the kind of the crazy character, which is, it's a little bit of what we were looking for. Like, you know, like people, like I'm not gonna, like if he doesn't want to have that name, I don't blame him. Like, yeah. I don't blame him from not wanting that name. And then the name's a tribute to people in his family. So,
right.
So I'm like, so get off the name, get off of, if you don't like it at that point, when you know how he got the name and it has something personal, get off of your personal feelings about the name.
Right. Like, right.
Okay.
And kudos to NXT for letting him have some creative control and letting him pick what he wanted for his name. Right.
Yep. Sure.
But
so,
Go ahead. I thought you were done.
No worries. But yeah, he had a pretty solid match. You could tell he's you could tell there's some, just like when he was in an AEW ring as well, like there's some kinks to work out, but
mm-hmm.
I think he will. Cause you could see it. It's there. It's in there. So good, but it's good, solid show. Good for Halloween Havoc.
Absolutely. Week two continues next week. WWE Premium Live Event heading to Berlin, Germany, August 31st, 2024. The WWE continues to just make it global. Yep. I like that they're doing this. It's going to be called the Bash in Berlin. And obviously, I've already gotten emails for pre-sale tickets and things like that to head over there. Sure. But kind of taking a page out of the NFL, or maybe the NFL is taking a page out of their book, where they're like, hey, let's try this international thing. And it's working. I mean, Puerto Rico, we had Money in the Bank in the UK this year. Obviously, Crown Jewel. All of these have been a success. I would like to see them be more of a big deal. I know, obviously, Money in the Bank kind of started that. But I don't want them to be these glorified house shows like Crown Jewel was for the first 2 years that it was in the rotation. So let's make this Bash in Berlin like a legit pay-per-view or premium live event, and have some title changes, have some big things happen.
I agree. I think they're like, I think this is all like they're walking towards a, you know, off the continent WrestleMania is basically what I think this is. So they're still, they want to make sure, because it's like, you know, again, kudos to AEW, what they did at Wembley. Like, that was still a lot of people. Okay, mm-hmm. That was still a lot of people to show up. But it was like, it was far from a sellout. And I think that's because they just kind of, like, the promo, I think just the lead up to it just did not give you a, like you're saying, a big fight global event. It did not have that feel to it. It was more of, hey, everybody, we're having this show.
Yep.
And if you don't like, if you want to show up WWE, you know, if you want to like make a point to WWE, show, like come to our show. That's basically what it felt like. And
yeah, I agree with that.
That's the crowd that you got. And so when they do go, they want it to be like, no, there's no doubt that there is not a seat left in this, you know, whatever they use, O2 or Wembley, and for two nights, like, you know, because they do their thing for two nights for WrestleMania. So
yeah,
I think that's what this is, like just getting everybody used to We're having big events over here. If you keep showing up, we'll keep bringing them.
Yep.
And so let's see, like, you know, and like you said, they're going to go to this, like, just the feel of, oh wait, there's a pay-per-view in Germany, we're going, you know.
Right, kind of. Right. It's a destination. Yes. So the other big news of this week, Impact is changing their name after the first of the year back to TNA. Everything that's old is new again. I don't hate this. I mean, I call them TNA. I actually almost wrote our sheet TNA changing their name back to TNA. And I was like, oh, I can't do that. I'm going to fuck myself up. But yeah, Impact going back to TNA. Again, going back, and Fabulous Disaster agrees here. It's hard to watch all this wrestling. I mean, hockey season started. I agree with that 100%, as you know. But it's tough to watch all of it. I want Impact to succeed. Obviously, the more that's out there, the more competition there is, the better for everybody, because everybody's putting on their A game. But yeah, man, it's just tough. It's tough to get into all of it or watch all of it. So
it is.
I follow tabs on TNA here and there. Like, I'll read what happened. Same thing with NXT, but it's just hard to watch it all. I don't even know what channel Impact's on right now, or TNA or whatever. And last week we missed it, but NWA signed a deal with the CW, apparently. They're getting off of YouTube, and they're going to go over to the CW. So even more wrestling to actually watch on TV. Just catching up on some comments here. King's debut was way more entertaining than anything they did with him in AEW.
I'm going to have to agree with that.
Yeah, that's from Chris Matthews.
Sliding in on the throne. That was great.
Jamal Paul with King, formerly known as Pillman Jr. I definitely see he has work to do, but I definitely think him going to NXT will be beneficial in the long run. Yeah, we saw Jade Cargill actually on TV
also
again.
On the throne. Yeah.
On
the two
throne.
AEW wrestlers on the thrones.
Yep. So
tell me that wasn't a poke at the, you know, when they smashed the throne.
Yeah.
When Cody first came out. So
yep, totally. And then the last bit of news I had here, if you guys are looking to spend more money in the world of wrestling, The Undertaker has launched a Patreon. Kind of a weird thing, but he set this up last week. It's titled 6 Feet Under with Mark Calaway and promises in-depth conversation about his wrestling career in podcast form. The last 30 plus years of being on the road as a professional wrestler has led to many stories in and out of the ring. Mark will be sharing weekly stories with you that probably have never heard before and taking you down memory lane with some of his most epic matches that we all love. So if you're interested in the world of professional wrestling, get a behind the scenes look into the life of one of the greatest wrestlers of all time. We'll grab your shovel and get ready to go 6 feet under with Mark Calaway. Actually, not as expensive as I thought this was going to be. $5, $6, and $10 a month tiers. I actually might check this out then. I figured it was going to be like $10, $15, $20, $25. It looks like $5 tier. The episodes will drop on Wednesdays. $5 for Wednesdays, Monday for $6 and $10 tier, and $10 tier will be able to submit questions for Callaway to answer in future episodes. That's not terrible. I might do the $5 a month one. Just to listen to him talk. When I first originally saw the article about it, it sounded like he was going to talk about stuff outside of the ring, which I did not want Undertaker's opinion on anything outside of the world of wrestling, because we've already got some of his opinions on stuff, and I'm just like, nah, I don't need to be listening to that. Yeah, there you go, guys. Sign up if you're interested in that. I know there's some big loyal Taker keeps trying to have kids. It's costing him all his royalties. I mean, he's got kids with his first wife. He's got kids with Michelle McCool. He's got kids all over the place. Hey. His daughter, one of his daughters, looks just like him, which is terrifying.
Oh man,
her.
But yeah, but going back to the pricing, I mean, I guess he figures, like, look, if I get, like, say, 100,000 people paying $5.
Exactly.
That's a nice chunk of change right there.
Absolutely.
So, you know, so that's, he's like, I don't, you know, this doesn't need to be overpriced because he has the numbers
right
already. Just his name has the numbers of people that would want to hear this stuff.
Absolutely.
So, and then $5, like, everybody, like, what's, you know, especially nowadays, like, something's $5. All right. You know, so, you know, at least to try. Right. So, I think it's brilliant. The pricing is brilliant, I think.
Fabulous Disaster. Run in Patreon or Taker? If you're getting free Taco Bell, man, then you should have plenty of money for Patreons. That's all.
That's right.
All right, time for winners and losers of the week. It's brought to you by J&J Figures. Make sure you subscribe on Patreon, speaking of Patreon, for an exclusive discount code for JJFigures.com. And make sure you check them out on whatnot. I don't have a winner of the week. I guess you could use Valkyra from NXT because she got that rub from Becky Lynch. Yeah. But my loser, I'm going with Darby Allin's face because he got a brand new face tattoo. Why? Why? I shared this in our group chat. Darby Allin is legitimately crazy. Our friend John James was telling me that when they had Billy Gunn at Zombie Hideout, Billy Gunn was telling them stories about Darby Allin, about how Darby Allin tries to get Billy Gunn to go over and do all kinds of crazy. They live next door to each other and do all kinds of crazy shit at his house. And I'm like, that all checks out. Yep. But I'm a big proponent of tattoos. I have a couple, 2, 3, 5 myself.
Right.
But I draw the line at face tattoos, man.
This guy, like, he, by the end of it, he's going to be covered. And I think he's one of those people that's just going to be all the way covered in tattoos, like all the way head to toe. So not surprising to me, but yeah, I can see how, like, it, to me, it didn't even look like you at least have a good tattoo on your face. Like this one, you know, I wasn't impressed with the, whoever the artist is. I'm sorry. Like,
yeah, I don't know. I don't even know what it's supposed to be. Veins or something, roots. I don't know.
Yeah. It didn't translate. So I still say Mike Tyson's face tattoo looks a little bit better.
Oh, Jack Purcell, friend of mine. I can't pull his comment up for some reason, but it says, I'm hoping to meet Darby Allin and Orange Cassidy at Rhode Island Comic-Con this week. Hey. Rhode Island Comic-Con is a huge, one of the biggest cons in the area here. Nice. Jack is actually a friend of mine. He's an artist, and I believe he's going to have a table there. So if you're going, make sure
you can show him a better tattoo.
Check that out. There it is. I think Britt Baker is going to be there.
Show him some work, Jack. Maybe he'll let you do some of his future tattoos.
But he will be there November 3rd through 5th. So I guess that's next weekend. Next weekend he'll be there. So all right, guys. Or DJ, what's your winners and losers? I'm sorry, got off track.
That's all right. So we did. So we kind of touched on Alexis King's entrance. I mean, you slide in on a throne, which, you know, and you got the leg up in there. That was dope. Sorry. Was like, hopefully they put that in a 2K game. That's a one of the when you make a character, that's one of the entrances you can have. Please. My loser is the Dark Order. Can we dissolve this group now? Like, I mean, are we done? I mean, like, this is like one of the original groups. You paid homage to Buddy Lee. Like, the group is a, you know, just a loser group. Like, can we stop now?
Yep. Yeah, even though a few of them have been to Blitzkrieg Pro, I am over that little
organization.
Group. Yeah.
Not the individual wrestlers are, you know, I'm not dogging them. Like, they're, you know, and you can tell they're pretty cool people. Like, you know, like,
Evil Uno was awesome when we met them.
Oh, yeah. But. No, I'd have a beer with every single one of them, but. But them as a group on this television show is just like
not cutting it.
Like the jobber group.
Why job squad?
Yeah, basically. So you know, let's cut the cord here.
Buy sell this week is brought to you by our boy Phil Gentile's book. Grab it on Amazon, The Official Guide to America's Toy Stores. If you haven't already, it's on Amazon for $11.99. So I saw Chris Matthews in our chat touch on this, thoughts on rumors of offers made to
Punk. Here we go.
TNA. That was my buy sell for this week. This is such a, I mean, we've talked about it again before a few times. I don't know why anybody would do business with Punk at this point, but I guess if you're trying to move that needle a little bit, I mean, I think it says a lot that WWE turned it down because I feel like WWE will give a second chance to most.
You can literally spit on Vince McMahon and still be able to come back.
Right, right. See, Bret Hart. But yeah, I don't see it happening. I don't see why anybody would do business with him at this point.
I'm selling. You're selling. At this point, I'm kind of buying. Not that it's a good idea. Like, I'm not debating you that it's a good idea. I'm just saying I think TNA can be at that. Like, we really need a name here. We need another name. And here's Punk. I'm pretty sure in their eyes are like, hey, he, you know, when he did premiere on AEW, he did move their needle.
Mm-hmm.
And we need it. So I can see them, you know, kind of quote selling their soul here and going for it.
That's exactly
who have they not? Wilson. Yeah. Never, definitely. See,
because I think Punk needs to get humbled, honestly. Then again, TNA definitely needs a TV deal. So if you get signed there, it can draw more interest.
Right.
I see why they would sign him. I can't picture anybody like the headache. Is it really worth it? You got to talk to the locker room, I think, too, if you're going to sign him.
Right.
Like, I think you got to say, hey, how do you guys feel about this? There's enough guys, I think, in TNA and Impact right now that have probably worked with him. Mm-hmm. But where they could give an honest opinion of like, hey, yeah, this will be good for business, but like, keep them away from me, or, you know, they'll have their general opinion. But
right. Because it's kind of like, you know, in sports when you have that player that's really good, but every team that he goes to, you know, it turns out it doesn't end well. Like, you know, see Terrell Owens, for example. and then everybody thinks it's a good idea when he's walking through the door, even though, oh, that just happened over there, or that was rumors or whatever. It'll be all right here. And then, you know, then he comes there and does the same thing. You know, this would be if he does sign, this would be a good test of what. So you had him, you know, as we think he acted up in the WWE locker room, and then allegedly he acted up in the TNA locker room. So if he does it in a third place, it's like, okay,
you know, AEW.
This would be the definite, like, anybody that still debates that CM Punk is a problem in the locker room. Okay, here's a third place,
right?
If he breaks this locker room up.
Yeah, some good points in the chat. Bully Ray.
Mm-hmm.
He's been very vocal about wanting him in Impact, but Bully Ray could also police him. Punk knows who he can try. You got Bully Ray, that'll sit him down as soon as he starts his shit, which that's true.
Yeah.
Modern day BSK judgment court, backstage court, right?
Yes.
What are you buying and selling this week?
So similar to this story, we got rumblings of Ospreay.
Yeah, give me
going
that.
Going to WWE.
Give me that.
I'm like, if you honestly, like, we're, you know, you're in New Japan and you honestly look at what's going on with the two companies and the things that have happened to the wrestlers that have gone from New Japan to AEW. Honestly, where are you going? Like, especially right. Somebody like Will Ospreay. So, you know, it's like after a while, there's a pattern. You know, like, you know, now one thing I don't buy is how everyone keeps telling me this is a young company and giving me all these excuses. I'm like, no, we're in 2023, about to be 24. You can't give me the years that a company has been. You've had enough time now to, mm-hmm. You've had enough experience in the building to teach you things.
Right.
All right. WWE just knows how to present a wrestler and make a character.
Look what they're doing with Jade, man. She hasn't even been on TV yet.
She hasn't even wrestled yet.
That's what I mean. She hasn't even wrestled yet.
Yep.
She's been on TV and they have her built up like a fucking star.
Right. You're ready to see Bianca Belair versus Jade right now.
Yeah, and I like how they
announced that
this
match right now. You would watch it.
Because, you know, like, when she is not on TV, she's getting that work in at the Performance Center.
Right.
Same thing will happen with Pillman Jr. Same thing. You bring Ospreay in, they'll give him that WWE shine. And man, so I will say this, he has been one of my favorites since I started watching AEW, because I didn't know a whole lot. I knew the name, but I didn't know a whole lot about him before AEW came around.
Right.
You know, their whole Forbidden Door stuff. Obviously seen a lot of him, and it's got me going in the archives and watching some of his old matches here and there when I have a spare time. And I really am an Ospreay fan. I would love it. I would love it if he signs with WWE. I think, and I know not everybody feels this way, but I feel like, and I heard Matt, I might be repeating myself here from a previous episode. I know Matt Cardona said this about Chelsea, that everybody should do WWE once just to see, just that's the goal, right? Like when you first start out, that's the goal for most people, is to do WWE. Without WWE, there is none of these other companies, right?
Right.
So try it once. If it doesn't work out, I mean, for Chelsea, it didn't work out twice, and now she's fucking killing it.
Right.
She is amazing. I think she should be women's champ eventually.
I think she will.
But I think, you know, guys like Ospreay, I would even like to see Kenny Omega in WWE at some point. All these guys, Ricky Starks, you know, have them jump back and forth like they were in the 90s, man, and see if they don't like it. You tried it and it's gone. I think I would use the reference before of ESPN was my dream job when I was in school.
That's right.
I got that job and I hated it and I left, and now I'm not doing anything in that field. So it's like, you got to at least try it though. I got there, I tried it. I realized this is not for me. This is not what I want to do. This is not the right fit for me. And I moved on. So maybe they do the same thing, right? Nothing like comparing a real life job to a wrestling or wrestler's job, right?
Hey, it's their job. Like it's real life for them.
That's right. That's right. So, all right, let's head to housekeeping here. That is it for the week in wrestling in the ring. Let's hit some housekeeping notes, and we'll be right back here in just a second.
Housekeeping.
No, thank you. Sleeping.
Housekeeping.
Could you come back in an hour?
Housekeeping, you want towels?
More towels. Need sleepy.
Housekeeping, you want me for a pillow?
Please go away. Let me sleep, for the love of God.
Housekeeping, you want me to jerk you off?
Housekeeping is brought to you by Homage. So I'm scrolling Facebook here while we're on the show, making sure our video's going through and all that stuff. And I see Homage changes a bunch of stuff on their Facebook page. Coming soon, the first ever officially licensed Tecmo Bowl collection.
Yes.
Give it to me. Oh, man. They've got a, like, they changed their profile picture to the old 8-bit helmet, and then their cover photo, Homage X Tecmo Bowl. Tecmo Bowl teams come in November 2nd. Tecmo Bowl Legends, November 16th. DJ, I think that means, you know, you're getting a Tecmo Bowl Bo Jackson shirt for
absolutely.
Sure. For sure.
Absolutely. We like, because of Bo Jackson, after a while, me and my friends, it was outlawed to be the Raiders.
It was like Michael Vick in 04 Madden, right?
Oh, man. So that was it. Nope, you can't be the Raiders. Anything but the Raiders, right? So so I had to go to the Bears after that.
If you guys have not been to Homage yet, make sure you hit up runinpod.com. Hit the deals link, click on Homage. That helps us out tremendously. They've got a ton of wrestling shirts. They've got a ton of pop culture shirts, NFL, MLB, college, all kinds of stuff. Check it out if you have not been there already. Let's hit up runinpod.com and then click on deals. And if you've never ordered from there before, you can use RunInPod and you'll save 15% off your first order. This week, our giveaway is coming to you from Wrestling Collector Shop, but it is coming through the means of the Fig Cave Facebook group. So if you are not a Patreon member, even more of a reason to sign up, because you get access to the Fig Cave. And we have been doing, we did it last week. We gave away the latest Rhea Ripley Elite. We did Free Fig Friday in the Fig Cave. So pay attention to that on Friday afternoon. October 27th, we will do some sort of free of Free Fig Friday. And we will maybe we'll do show us your best wrestling Halloween costume or something like that. And I've got a Commissioner Foley Elite to give away, courtesy of Wrestling Collector Shop, that we'll throw in there. Lucas Weiser was last week's winner in the Free Fig Friday in the Fig Cave Facebook group. So make sure you have make sure you are signed up if you are not already. And speaking of Patreon, we've got tiers just like the Undertaker. $1, that's better. That's better than the Undertaker's. That's $1, right. $5, and $10. Go sign up. It's patreon.com/runinpodcast. Or sorry, runinpod. Tons of benefits for being a Patreon. You get the episode early and ad-free. You get video. I know some of you guys are watching on video right now live while we're recording this. You get a sticker. But you can also watch the video of you can also see the video of us every week, not just when we decide to hit the button. Ad-free content. Yeah, we're putting more ads into our shows. If you're listening normally on Friday, but that's because we want to kind of push you guys over to the Patreon side. So for $5, you would be getting a ad-free version of the show and free or early, ad-free and early. All kinds of good stuff. $1, $5, $10. Tiers, you guys can check it out over at patreon.com/runinpod if you haven't already. The biggest thing is getting access to that Fig Cave Facebook group, man. I know, DJ, I kind of bamboozled you a little bit here this past week. You were supposed to help me out getting the Rob Van Dam Ultimate
Mattel
Edition.
Mattel store didn't help me out. So.
The Mattel store was closed. And
they have weird hours, man. Like you go there and it's like you're rolling a dice that it's gonna be open, like kind of thing.
I'm chatting with Chad Miller. He's at Walmart, and I'm trying to get this Rob Van Dam Ultimate Edition so I can get it signed for over at a big event in New York when Nikki Chocos from the Fig Cave podcast. And DJ's supposed to be getting it for me, and Chad Miller comes through. It's a Facebook group, man. He just sends me a message. Yeah. He's like, "You looking for anything? I'm at Walmart." And I'm like, "Let me know if they got that Rob Van Dam," and he had it. So he just put it in the mail for me today. So I paid retail plus shipping for it. Can't beat that. Wife found that for me, actually, while she was in Savannah, Georgia this past week. But she was like, "I don't know how I'm going to get this home, and I can't promise you it'll be home in, like, good condition." And I told her, like, I wanted it for a signing. So if I wanted it loose, I'd be like, just open it and throw it in a Ziploc baggie on your way. Right. And throw it in your suitcase. But, yeah. So that's a huge reason to get the Patreon. And then we do give you 15% off at jjfigures.com. That's exclusive to Patreons only. And this month, we do a monthly giveaway every month. That's what monthly means. This month, Wrestling Collector Shop is hooking it up. A huge badass giveaway. It is all three of the latest edition of the Ultimate Editions. Bianca Belair, Bobby Lashley, and Kurt Angle. You're getting all three. We're not giving one to one winner, one to another winner, one to a third winner.
No.
You're getting all three. One winner is getting all
in.
Whole collection of Ultimate Edition 19 is what it is. So courtesy of Wrestling Collector Shop, and those should be in shortly.
I think you'll be pressed to find a podcast as what a better giveaway than that. Like, what?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yep. So make sure you get in if you haven't already. You got until the end of October. You got 5 days as we record this. So Blitzkrieg Pro is back in action in Holyoke, Massachusetts, November 17th. We got Sonny Kiss who debuted on TNA last week, versus Dirty Dango, formerly known as Fandango. Tickets are on sale now at blitzkriegpro.net. And the Fig Cave Toy Drive is coming back. We'll have more details on that in the next few weeks. If you guys donate, we'll probably hook you guys up with a prize. And we are also try to hook you up with a prize. We'll do some kind of drawing if you guys donate. But we're also doing got to get the details, but the Game Marks podcast, we're teaming up with those guys. They are doing a live stream of video games, and we are going to sponsor that and help out with that, give away a prize on that stream as well. And then, of course, guys, we always ask you, please rate, review, and subscribe on Apple Podcasts if you haven't already. Check out runinpod.com. Grab some merch over at merch.runinpod.com. And that, I believe, is it for housekeeping. Unless you got anything to throw in there, DJ.
No, I think you done covered it. All right. Again, that main event, though, going back to the Blitzkrieg, that is, that's a damn, like, you know, I'd pay the front row cost.
Front row, that one. Front row already sold out.
Damn.
So okay, you missed out.
Or second row. Even one of the two, like when I go to shows like that, I like to be in the first two rows.
Yeah. Dude, honestly, like, I haven't somebody, been to this...
So they fall in your lap.
I haven't been to this new venue that they've been at, but like the action would find you. Any their old venue in Enfield, Connecticut, that would find you anywhere you were sitting. It's pretty nice. Good. So nice. Definitely a blast. Those Blitzkrieg Pro shows. I'm gonna definitely be in the house at that one November 17th. So if you guys are going, hit me up with a message. I'll bring some stickers with me along and stuff. I'll bring some stickers along with me and all that stuff. So with that being said, guys, it's time for Falls Count Anywhere.
Falls Count Anywhere here. Falls Count Anywhere.
They are going everywhere. Look at this.
This is Falls Count Anywhere.
Falls Count Anywhere is the part of the show where we talk about whatever the hell we want to talk about. Wrestling. It's brought to you by Wrestling Collector Shop. You guys can use RUN10 to save 10% on anything you were going to buy over there. You were going to buy figs anyway. You might as well save 10% over at Wrestling Collector Shop. All their new stuff is in stock. I believe it's Elite 104, 105, Royal Rumble figures. All those in stock now and shipping. So if you have not grabbed them, make sure you do. Lots of comments here. In our chat, Jamal Paul says he was sad that it was announced that giveaway was announced right after he pre-ordered all three of them. Well, bro, you could get, you know, Kurt Angle does a ton of signings, so keep one mint on card if you win.
That's right.
Plus, if you order anything from them in October, you'll get an extra entry. Javier Diaz, I see your message
Bianca
about the bat
signings too. So
yep, she's been teaming up with Fitterman lately. Javier Diaz, I see your message about the Batman animated series figures. We can talk about those right now. DJ wanted those. We talked about them a couple weeks ago, actually. I've not actually seen them in stores yet, but DJ did. I actually saw that the Bat Cycle was like mispriced. It was coming up as the same price as the figures for a little bit. I don't know if that's been fixed or not. But
what was the price that was coming up?
It was like what are the figures? $29.99?
Yep.
Yeah, it was coming up as that, and I think the Bat Cycle was supposed to be $49.99.
Oh, well, if I would have found that.
Right. Target's had some banger coupons in there as well.
That's right.
In their app. I just used, I pre-ordered that Hulk Hogan 3-pack when it dropped San Diego Comic-Con week. I canceled my original order. I used the 25% off coupon for that. And then I had like $15 in like the Target circle money. So I used that as well. So I got it for like under $50 for three of them. Now I just hopefully fingers crossed it'll ship.
We talk about the bullseye, the eBay bullseye thing and how the figures show up to your house?
Like, bro, that was my weekly purchase last week. My Xbox was smashed to shit. Why'd you order something?
No, because I guess like because I saw someone else like show pictures of the result and how that and like it you can't even put into words how beat up the box was.
So Phil owed me a Bradshaw Legends figure. That was one of my weekly purchases a couple weeks ago, and he ordered it from that thinking he was going to save time and money, and again it was $11.99 free shipping,
right?
Great deal. But they shipped it in like one of those paper bags or plastic bags that like you would get a t-shirt in or something, right. And then I ordered X-Pac last week, part of my weekly purchases from last week. I ordered X-Pac. If you go back to last week's show and watch the video, the thing was smashed to shit. The figure itself was fine.
Figure is fine. Yeah.
But the box, if you're looking for a signing or whatever, or you're an MOC collector, I would not recommend ordering from Target Bullseye. Unless I haven't ordered, I was actually just thinking about this today. I haven't ordered more than one thing at a time yet. So I don't know if maybe you order two, they throw it in a box for you instead of the plastic bag, but both things have come smashed and both things have come in a plastic bag and both the actual figures were fine. And yeah, that Target Bullseye, man, you can search for Marvel Legends. You can search for video games. You can search for WWE figures. They just put some new stuff up actually, like the Million Dollar Man Legends is up there, the green suit one. So, but yeah, that Target Bullseye app is no joke. But just be prepared. So, Major Bendy's announced they've got Eddie Guerrero under contract, and they'll be making a Major Bendy of Eddie Guerrero. Not sure when that goes on sale, but those are the major pod guys. $12.99 starting lineups are showing up. The NBA starting lineups. Oh, what could have been, man. I don't know where Hasbro dropped the ball on these, but they were $30 to start. And then you got a NFT with them. And then now they're $12.99 at Marshalls and TJ Maxx.
Because you need legends.
You mean LeBron really James dope. Isn't a legend?
Pat legends from the past. of course, you know, once he's said and done, like once his career said and done, of course he's gonna be in the conversation.
Right.
So I'm not saying that.
Oh yeah, I know. I'm just
but yeah, but you need Barkley. You need like just like the original starting lineup. You had all these, you had everybody, and then they went into the past, right? They, you know, you can get Bob Cousy and all those guys. So
yeah,
Miguel, Yep. So that's where they dropped the ball. They only had like six figures, and they were all current guys, which is not a bad thing, but it's not speaking to the market. Like you're marketing to us.
Mm-hmm.
And so we are guys that, with sports where we're nostalgic.
Right.
So you got to bring those players. Like so I think if they would have had like maybe 10 players, and give me 5 from current, and then give me 5 Hall of Famers.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that would have been better. You would have gotten some sales.
Yeah.
But
how do you throw Jordan in your first set, right? Like,
right. It's just like, you know, I'm not going out to look for, like, as good as he is. Like, I'm not saying he's not a good player, but I'm Giannis Antetokounmpo. I'm not going to go looking through Targets or wherever to find his action figure. Like,
right.
He's not pushing a needle like that. So
yeah,
that's what they saw there.
To circle back, Fabulous Disaster said he received a Rock Ultimate from Bullseye in a box and it was fine. Hmm. Nice. I assume that's from the eBay account, not from Target, because I got the Rock Ultimate Edition from Target too, and it was in a box. But like actual Target, not the eBay Bullseye deals. But
the eBay Bullseye deals were rolling the dice.
Jamal Paul chiming in again on Hasbro. I've kind of slacked on Hasbro just because I got out of the Marvel Legends. I'll pay attention here and there to like what they're dropping. I'm out on Star Wars. I don't give a shit about Power Rangers. Like that hasn't been my thing ever. Transformers.
I do want to do a selfie.
Yeah. I don't know, man. Even those still look weird, but Hasbro's been slacking on everything except Transformers and Marvel. Everything else seems as if they've given up on other lines. My thing with Hasbro is like, Star Wars. Okay, cool. The Black Series is amazing. I don't need 40 different versions of Darth Vader or Han Solo or whatever. I don't need the new shows, figures, and stuff like that. Right. Marvel Legends are still doing a great job with. And one thing that was pissing me off about Hasbro is like you're ordering from the source on Hasbro Pulse, right? And you're the last one to get it. If you order on Amazon, you get it sooner. You can find it in store sooner. Then you got to go in and cancel your order. That was pissing me off with Hasbro Pulse, especially for a while there. I don't know if it's still the case because I canceled, but I haven't even been on their website in quite a bit, but like you had to pay for Hasbro Pulse. It was like $70 a year.
That's right.
So if I'm paying for a service, you better be giving me my figures sooner than later.
Right.
But I haven't bought much from Hasbro myself in a while. I am looking for that Wolverine 97 though. The throwback packaging and blue and yellow,
the one where he has the portrait of Gene.
No.
I have that one.
No, this is one. I'm actually on Hasbro Pulse.
It looks like, I know what you're talking about. Like, it's like the TV, it's got the look like it's from the TV show.
Yeah, it's an old school packaging. Yeah, it's like the vintage, vintage packaging and stuff. I have not seen those in stores. It's in my Amazon cart, but I have not pulled the trigger on it yet. Mm-hmm. Because they still do have the animated series one. I actually have this one. And I haven't opened it. I should. I have the box.
Every now and then I see those
with him holding the picture.
Yeah. No, the '90s
the 97 ones.
Yeah, I've seen those off and on. Yeah,
damn, I've not seen them in stores yet. So, I'll pull the trigger eventually on Amazon. I'll get impatient and decide to do it. But, not a whole lot of toy news this week. To be honest with you guys, if you guys are in the chat and you want our opinion on something, or you want, you got questions, shoot them in there. We'll answer them while we're doing this. But what's up, TNT? 26 times.
There he is.
I was wondering if you were going to drop on. Chad Miller actually does say, DJ, did you see the pre-order for the Sting statue on Entertainment Earth?
And I did it.
Oh, you did it. All right. Yeah. How much was that running?
I think they're 50. Yeah.
Is that the same company that's doing the CM Punk and Daniel Bryan?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, those honestly are badass. They look great. I would love for WWE and Mattel to do something. I mean, I don't think Mattel's the one making these, but for WWE to do something like that.
No, because like you said, it's like, you know, I have The Rock. Like if you, my, like this way, like you can see The Rock right there with the older, if you remember those, were those the Unleashed or whatever? Like what were they
Unmatched.
Called?
Yeah, Unmatched.
Unmatched, Fury. Yeah. So Unmatched Fury, yeah. So they can do something like that. I think they should do something like that again, because that's basically what the statue reminds me of. Is the Unmatch Fury.
There it is.
Yeah.
It does. They look good, man. The pose that he's on is on the steps like that. That's badass. Give me a Ric Flair or something like that. I have the Ric Flair Unmatch Fury from Jax, and I have the Hulk Hogan. The Hulk Hogan.
Okay.
Some of those were like hit and miss though. Like some of them looked really good, and then other ones just looked like shit. But
the Undertaker one, I have like, you know, I have to keep getting, I have to keep super gluing him to the mat because
I do that with Ric Flair.
Yeah. Because the way he's posed, he goes forward.
Yeah.
Because he's bowing his head. So it's making the weight of the figure go forward. So every so often he'll fall forward.
Yeah, Jamal says WWE made statues a few years ago, but they were like $200 a piece. I think those were Hot Toys or Sideshow.
And that's the pre-order price. If you wait till they come out, that price jumps up quite a bit.
Yep, absolutely. So it would be cool to see something like that. So they got CM Punk, Daniel Bryan, and Sting, and I think there's a Moxley one too. I could be wrong on that one though. But all right. So that's it really for the world wrestling news, figure news. No Ninja Turtles to talk about, nothing. So we are going to do our top five Halloween themed wrestlers. So as soon as you said this, DJ.
The worst.
Five worst. I thought of the whole new generation era, because everybody in the new gen had like another job, like the Goon, Duke Dumpster Drozy, like all the Mantar. Like these are all like terrible costumes that these guys are wearing,
right? Which I wouldn't blame you for picking any, like, you know. I kind of went like,
I just unplugged my headphones, give me 1 second, so I can't hear anything. All
right. Yeah, but all right, what I was going for was like something, you know, that is would be like somebody you would, you know, one of the ghouls or goblins or whatever that would be like Halloween kind of type thing. But if you did pick like something like I'd count it, because that was poor guy. I gotta be this tough garbage man.
Yeah. Who do you got for number five?
Number five, speaking of new generation, so it's not, so I was able to find somebody that I thought fit the deal, was Fantasio.
Oh dude, I have him as number four.
Okay, by the way, like, so my honorable mention, I got two honorable mentions because I thought they were low-hanging fruit, so I didn't pick them, and that was Shockmaster and Seven are my honorable mentions, because I thought they were, I'm like, that's too low-hanging fruit, I want to dig a little deeper here.
All right, my number five is someone we haven't seen for a while but is current. It is Abaddon.
Oh, yeah, we haven't seen it.
Such a terrible look.
Oh, man.
She's getting a figure. She's been on TV probably as like you can count on your fingers how many times she's been on TV.
Right.
But she's got a toyetic look, and what says Halloween more than a zombie?
True.
But number four, as I said, I had Phantasmo. Who'd you have?
All right. So a shout out to our boy Brian Clark.
No,
he had another character in WCW. Wrath.
Yep.
Wrath was horrible.
Wow. Yep. I might have some news about Wrath in the next couple weeks. Just saying.
Here we go. Just
saying. A little teaser there. Number three, I had Shockmaster.
All right.
You can't not have him on the list. The man is legitimately wearing a Stormtrooper helmet painted in glitter. If that doesn't say Halloween, what does?
It took a year to get like all of the glitter that was probably all over his body and in that whatever room they were spray painting that in. You had glitter for a year.
Everywhere. Who's your number three?
The Kiss Demon.
Kiss Demon.
Yes. The Kiss Demon. Poor guy. Again, poor guy. He was supposed to get a push.
Yep.
But then Kiss was like, yeah, we're out. And then they're like, okay, but we have this guy. We don't know what to do with him now that Kiss is out. So then he just proceeded to go out there and get his head kicked in every week.
I'm pretty sure Nick Thompson met him at big event last year because he was like, you got a free meet and greet with him if you bought a ticket.
Oh, snap. Okay.
Yeah. Number two, I've got Max Moon, which I would love a figure of, but he was not a great wrestler, even though it was Conan for a time. And honestly, like toyetic looked great, but a great costume. But yeah,
he'd go up there with my Quicksilver the way his costume.
Actually, Bill McKenna posted something on Instagram a while back, and I mentioned we need a Max Moon Elite, and he said the deco would just be too expensive. Who knows? Conan's in the Hall of Fame now, though. Or no, he inducted Ray into the Hall of Fame. But who knows? Maybe we'll get a Conan figure. Maybe we could get Max Moon as well now. Because they said the Gobbledygooker was too much deco at one point, too. But
right. Which is probably to throw us off.
Yeah, that's true. Who do you got for number two?
Number two, the WCW Zombie.
I forgot about him.
Yes.
Man, you could have a whole WCW segment of this category.
Yep.
I forgot all about him. My number two is Max Moon, as we said. And then number one for me, I got Mantar. How are you going to not pick a man wearing a horse mask?
That was, it was like not even proportionate. it was horrible. and then my number one, like, because when I was telling Tommy, like, we were going to do this, I said, this can only be one pick because you can take the whole group and take up your whole five. So is the WCW Dungeon of Doom is my number one, like, all of them. Like,
yeah, they were honorable mention for me.
Especially the Yeti. Like, the Yeti probably taking the top spot.
Patience,
there it is.
Javier. Yeah, he said, nobody mentioned the Yeti. Number one, that's number one, man.
And then the Chris vibrating bear hug as his as his finisher.
Chris Matthews says Abaddon was out with an injury, but she has a great look and awesome person to meet. Hosted her for a horror convention I held a couple weeks ago. So
nice. I can see that. I can see her being at a horror convention.
Yep, absolutely. We do have a couple questions here in the chat. If you guys want to throw a couple more in, if you got something to ask us. I want to talk about horror movies though, DJ. This has been a topic here. You guys can also throw your top fives in, or if you got an honorable mention for Halloween themed wrestlers. Horror movies. I am not a horror movie man at all.
All right.
And I've been doing horror movie trivia in my shoot job all week. And it just got me thinking, like, why do people really want to pay money to have the shit scared out of them? Whether you're going to like a haunted house, or like a haunted hayride, which is big here in New England. Like, why am I going to pay $70 or $50 to have somebody jump out of a cornfield with a fake chainsaw or a chainsaw with the chain undone and scare the shit out of me? Like, why is that a good time for people? I'm not a horror movie guy at all. I think I might have shared the story before. Insidious was a movie that me and the wife tried to watch a couple years ago. And we were both so freaked out that we ended up just putting Dumb and Dumber on, like 20 minutes into it. 20 minutes into it.
That, wow, 20 minutes in.
Yeah.
The movie that, like, before I answer that, the movie that messed me up was The Return of the Living Dead.
Never seen
it. Oh, yeah. So it messed me up for a minute. Like, it was one of those when I saw it, like, it was on, you know, watching it on HBO one night, and then I had to put on, before I went to bed, I had to put on the Disney Channel because that was, my head was all the way messed up. But it's the adrenaline, man. I think it's the, because it, you know, once after you get scared, notice that you have, like, you know, you have a little bit of dopamine from the adrenaline going through your body. So it just, it kind of, you know, it makes you, like, ironically feel alive again. And it, you know, it's a, like, it's the feeling after the scare is what people, it kind of feels good. So I think that's why people like to get scared and go to things that they know will scare them and things like that. It's science.
Yeah. I get it a little bit, but
yeah, I'm with you though. Why are we doing this to ourselves on purpose? Like, I don't know why, like, I guess because it's like a train wreck. I want to see, like, this new Exorcist movie where there's like two girls that get, and it's a true story. Like, that's the other thing that you got to have in your head when you go to watch this. And, you know, just like a, you know, dumpster fire or train, you know, train wreck, whatever, you just can't turn away.
We were talking about this last night with some friends that the girl, what's the name of the girl who played the original girl in The Exorcist?
Oh,
I forgot her name. Linda Blair.
I forgot her name, but I know who you're talking
Linda
about.
Linda Blair. She dated Rick James at one point, and Rick James came out and said that she was like a freak in the sheets. Now,
yeah,
if for
Rick
one
James
thing,
says that.
That's exactly what I was going to say. I was going to say, for Rick James to say she's a freak, I feel like is way different than me or you saying someone's a freak. Second of all,
way different.
She's possessed. Of course she's going to be a freak. Come on, man.
Well, when you're a teenager and in a movie, they ask you to masturbate.
With a cross,
and tell the priest to, like, as you're looking the priest in the face to fuck you. I think you're gonna grow up and be liberated. I'll say when it comes to shoot sex.
Javier Diaz says top five horror movies: Nightmare on Elm Street, 4, It, Paranormal Activity, 3. House of a Thousand Corpses and The Conjuring.
Conjuring, which is a true story.
Me and my wife did watch Scream last Halloween. That was fine.
Scream is more, I think that's more of a almost thriller? Murder mystery. Yeah.
Yeah. That's, I was going to say that. Like, I saw The Shining for the first time in the theater a couple of years ago. It was like one of the anniversaries of The Shining. Yeah. And they put it back in the theater. And a bunch of friends went. And they're like, man, I'm super jealous. This is your first time seeing it. And it was in the theater. I loved it. But I don't feel like that's a horror movie to me. I feel like that is more like a thriller. Like, same thing, even with The Exorcist, like, I don't feel like that's super horror movie. It's these ones that are like mind fucks with you and like, and they got the jump scares and stuff like that. I don't feel like even, I don't want to say Nightmare on Elm Street because that is pretty freaky, but like some of these older ones, I tried to watch It a couple of years ago, the original It, and I was just like, this isn't super scary. It's just, it's way too long for one thing. Sorry, Javier. But,
How long is that? Was it? Is that
I remember back in the day, it was two VHS tapes.
That's true. Yeah, that you're right. I remember that.
Because my cousin lived with us for a little while, and he had it. But let me see. Running time for the original It. 192 minutes. So that's about, that's long. That's long, but. And I get those movies came out in different times and stuff where things were different, but all right. So what do we got left here? I think we got NFL. Meh.
NFL.
Eh.
You don't want to talk in it.
I mean, the Pats had a huge win this week, but I was just talking about some friends, talking about this with some friends that nobody is the greatest team in the NFL right now. Like, Eagles lost, 49ers lost. Yeah, there's a ton of parity. Like, the Bear, like my buddy's a Bears fan. If they win this week, they could be 3-5 and still realistically have a chance. If the Pats win this week, they could be 3-5 and have a chance. But it's like, right. Yeah, we just beat the Bills this week. And it's like, okay, now we play the Dolphins and I have no idea what to fucking expect. It also makes gambling on the NFL very hard and frustrating. I have not done any DraftKings.
With the parody of the NFL.
Not frustrated. It's just like everybody gets all worked up week to week. And it's like nobody knows shit about fuck, to quote my girl from Ozarks.
That's
like
that's funny.
It literally
Which is good. I think that's a good thing.
Yeah, I think it keeps everybody guessing. But it's like every element, you have no idea what's going to happen in fantasy, gambling, the actually cheering for your team. Like I didn't think the Pats had a shot against Buffalo this week.
I didn't either.
And here we are talking about them winning. I forget who the Raiders play this week, this past week.
Somebody we lost to. well, because like you had, I don't have no idea why they would start Hoyer instead of the rookie.
Kid?
Yeah, like dude, just put him in there now. Like what are we doing? But it was the Bears.
Yeah, they lost to the Bears. That's right. Yep.
Who had a freaking Division II quarterback?
Yep,
as their rookie Division II quarterback and lost. So that's why I'm just like, yeah. Can we just get to the draft now? Like for
no way, man. We still got 10 beautiful weeks of this season left.
I know. And then watch them mess around and win games. They probably shouldn't. we'll be close to 500 for no reason at all. But at least like it's a talented draft, though. I'll say that. Like that should be coming out, unless like some of these kids are like, shoot, I'm getting paid more than I would
right
rookie year. So
right, and that kid from USC wants like a cut of the ownership for whatever team drafts
him. At this point, I'd give it to him.
Yeah, no way, no way. All right, couple quick questions here from our chat here, if I can find them. We Are Wrestling. They are a fellow Blitzkrieg Pro sponsor and supporter. Make sure you guys subscribe to them on YouTube. Who's your favorite Blitzkrieg Pro wrestler? I'll answer this, DJ, since you haven't been to one yet. Those of you who don't know, DJ is out on the West Coast, so hasn't been here for the East Coast show of a Blitzkrieg or for a Blitzkrieg show. But next time he's out here, we got to take him to one. Yes. My favorite Blitzkrieg Pro wrestler ever, CPA. If you guys don't know CPA, look up CPA Wrestles on Instagram. He is the wrestling accountant. He is a peach. I think I like him more than I like Ric Flair, to be honest with you.
Wow.
Yep. Our boy Kenny to call up says, if you could get any old school video game remade, what would it be? And what would you add new? I got an immediate answer for this. You need a second to think about that?
I do.
I would go 100% I'm trying to click that off. I would 100% go with No Mercy. I would have updated with obviously the newer rosters, but keep those old rosters in there, put legends in there and updated arenas, but keep everything else the same. Keep the graphics the same, keep the gameplay the same, maybe make the music a little bit better. Cause the music was very MIDI. I think like the keyboards,
of course,
but other than that, man, No Mercy, probably my favorite video game of all time.
Okay.
Not just wrestling game, video game.
Right.
GoldenEye would be dope to remake too, actually, now that I'm thinking about like that Nintendo 64 realm.
I think they tried, but you just can't. Like it was the game, like GoldenEye was the game and what we had seen so far when GoldenEye came out. So it's just like it's hard to go back after like that game was one of those, it was hard to go back.
Yeah,
but they tried.
I feel like even No Mercy. I mean, some of those SmackDown
versus Raw.
Not SmackDown ones. Versus Raw. What was the other one?
Know Your Role.
Know Your Role. Those games in the mid-2000s, those were really good for PlayStation 2.
They were.
But no, I feel like nothing has topped No Mercy yet. Like, just all this different stuff you could do.
Yep.
And it was just fun to play.
But. Right. The WCW equivalent to that game, I thought were
revenge.
Go back and forth. Yeah.
Yep. You got an answer for your game?
Yeah, I think I would do Contra.
Oh yeah.
And then not a side scroll, like make it not a side scroll, like make it like an open world kind of a thing, but with the same kind of like, you know, you're fighting like all these aliens that that invaded and you have all the weapons that you can get, I would do that. I would do some Contra, like, but modernized.
We're way off topic here. We're just kind of spitballing, which is fine.
That's all right. That's what live is about.
That's right. I have said for the longest time, there should be an open world Walking Dead video game where, like, it's like Grand Theft Auto, where you can take cars and stuff like this, and then all of a sudden a zombie apocalypse happens, and you literally have to, like, try to get from wherever to wherever, but you could be driving down the road, you run out of gas, zombies come out of nowhere. Like, an open world Walking Dead, I feel like, would be phenomenal.
But that's pretty dope.
They
kind of did it with PlayStation, with Days Gone, but it's still not the same feel. Like, it even had a guy that looks like Daryl from Walking Dead, but it's not the same. It's not the same, but to have it actually be Walking Dead and have the things that happen in the show happen in the game and you have to survive, I think would be great. This one they have now where you pick, you know, one of those, like, it's like one of those storyboard kind of things. Just make a game.
Agreed.
It's Walking Dead. We'll play it.
All right, last question. Javier Diaz says, what's your favorite Halloween episode on a show? Family Guy, Roseanne, Simpsons, etc. I mean, you got to go Treehouse of Horrors with The Simpsons. Those are all memorable. I don't really remember a Halloween episode of Roseanne. Sorry. I watched
They had
Roseanne.
The best costumes on Roseanne. Them and Blackish, I think, every Halloween, their costumes were on hit.
I don't remember any of the Halloween episodes of Roseanne. No. I just remember
the costumes. I don't, like you said, I don't remember what happened in the episodes.
I don't remember a ton of from Family Guy either. But so Simpsons Treehouse of Horrors has to be it for me because A, I'm a huge Simpsons fan, and B, it's just they're memorable to me.
I was about to say, in an episode, is for me, it's easily Forbidden Donut.
Yeah, yep, 100%. But,
Forbidden
all right.
Donut.
Time for weekly purchases, DJ. I will let you go first. I know you've been in and out of that Mattel store. You've been hunting at Target. Like you said, you pre-ordered the Sting statue.
Right.
Anything else?
All right. So so officially Spider-Man 2.
Oh, yeah.
That came out. If you are following my Twitch, you'll see me pop on.
Nice.
Every now and then and see me swing around the city. Mm-hmm. So this week, we're going to give a shout out to our sponsor, Wrestling Collections.
Collector Shop.
Yes, Wrestling Collector Shop. You know what the hell I'm doing. But anyway, so first, our boy, Johnny Knoxville, the world champion.
Yeah, that's a great figure.
Yeah, they did a great face sculpt there.
Yeah.
And so he'll be up there. I really like that one. And then Viva La Raza, the champ.
Nice.
And my favorite title. This is my favorite title. Like
that one that came with that figure is so freaking big, though. I don't know if they're trying to be like he took it from Brock and that's why it's so big.
Title itself, like, so once I got this title, I don't think we realize how big this title is. Like, this is the biggest title. Like, it's like almost double the size of my yellow Intercontinental one.
Okay.
It's a big title. So when you actually have it in your hand, like the replica. So I see why they made, like, so I think they did probably put this to scale. Cause it's a huge title. Like, I'm telling you.
And how big of a pain in the ass was it to get that shirt on him?
Oh God. This shirt is skin, like, so, like he's saying, like, the shirt is skin type, and then, like, there is no, like, there's no, you know, like, you know how they sometimes have the Velcro tearaway to make it easier. They did not do that this time. So, yes, that, like, you know, I had to put, like, something, you know, as I was watching television or something, as I was easing this on, his huge, but at least... One thing that helped
was his, like, because they made his joints go so far back like this. So that helped me get it on. But if they didn't have that, I don't think that it would have been impossible.
That's the Eddie Guerrero Ultimate Edition, by the way, for those of
Eddie
you
Guerrero who Ultimate are Edition.
Just listening. I actually pulled the arms off of him because it's the Ultimate. So, like, obviously you can pop stuff out here and there. So I popped the arms out. Kind of a gamble. But yeah, I popped the arms off and the head and got it on. So, and apparently that's what Fabulous Disaster said, as he says in the comments. But all right, for me, again from Wrestling Collector Shop, I got our man Virgil, friend of the show. He's done an intro for us. We hung out with him in Albany, New York. This Virgil,
some great stories there.
is the Build-A-Figure. From the Royal Rumble set. So it is him in his candy stripe shorts or tights. Wrestling Collector Shop, you guys always have to keep an eye out. We've talked about it before. They offer the Build-A-Figures for a price, so you don't have to buy the whole set and then sell the whole set. Or, like, I had no interest in any of those Royal Rumble figures, but I wanted Virgil. I don't know if you can do it with the Survivor Series Bulldog yet, but keep an eye. They actually put Virgil on his on their eBay store. So definitely. Definitely keep an eye out for that. And then from our friend Dougie Nunez's Patreon group, T4L, I got this Stone Cold Steve Austin for $20 shipped, which I thought was a great price. I didn't even need the figure. I wanted the belt because I have one of these belts already, and I wanted to put it on Hall and Nash as I'm redoing the whole display. And there he said $20 for the – I asked if anybody had the belt, and he said he had the figure. So, again, collectors helping collectors, man. And I got the whole – I could resell that belt if I want for more than $20. I don't know if he knows that or not, but so shout out to Vincenzo who hooked me up with this figure for a great, great, great price. So I will still put this. I love this Steve Austin figure. Now I have to get the Pillman though,
right?
Which is not cheap. But I love the Hollywood Blonde Steve Austin. I'm gonna put that in my WCW shelf. And other than that, I've got some stuff that'll be coming in the mail. Chad Miller hooking me up with that RVD. So other than also, that, man, I pre-ordered some stuff this week. But
yeah, because one other while I was pre-ordering the Sting, I also like that. I don't know if we talked about this figure, the Super 7 Zartan.
Mm-hmm.
That actually does change its color in sunlight. So once, like, which I've said this, I was like, I will get the Zartan when they, because Zartan is one of my favorite characters in the G.I. Joe universe. And
yep.
I'm like, but when they make a figure that changes color in sunlight, I'm buying it. And then there you go, Super 7 doing it again.
Yep. Chad Miller just posted those Super 7s are actually showing up in Walmart.
They do. Yeah, they do show up in Walmart.
But $55 American. Hey, Phil Gentile joined us. What's up, Phil?
And that's why you got to take your time with Super 7.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
It's one of those every now and then kind of purchases.
I did pre-order the Macho Man Major Bendy. I could not pass that up. It just looks so good. He'll go with my Ric Flair. Redid a bit of the fig room, my office, whatever you want to call it this week. So I'm going to have some pictures up. I talked about it a little bit last week, grabbed some IKEA shelves, and put up my autograph figs. I should be getting some autograph figs back in the mail this week or next week. So, kind of a light week for weekly purchases, but that's okay. I got to save some money here and there. So,
but
I think that's it for, weekly purchases. What you watching this week, DJ?
So of course everybody's watching NFL. NBA started
Celtics last night. 1-0.
Yeah. And then right after that game, the debut of Wembanyama.
That dude is so, I know he's huge, but he is so weird looking.
It's like a 2K player that you would make, you know, to like just be able to score all, like, and dunk over everybody, and you can't even shoot a jump shot over him because he's so long.
His arms, something like Space Jam. I feel like
it feels like when I would like play on those elementary school size courts where they're like, you know, the basket's like maybe 6.5 feet, maybe 7. Like that's what it looks like for him on a real size court.
Yeah.
So I think, and then he's nimble, and then he's not Manute Bol. Like he the man can handle the ball and, you know, and go and dribble around you. Mm-hmm. So it's a unicorn out there. This is like a real, we're seeing like a real life unicorn playing basketball. And
absolutely.
So yeah, he, everything expected. He came out there. He even put on a little weight, like make sure he had some weight on him before he went out there. I'm impressed. I was impressed by him.
Sorry. I didn't mean to cut you off. Go ahead. Go ahead.
No worries. On Netflix, check out Old Guys with Bill Burr, and Bill Burr is the director of this movie. Funny movie. Like especially for us dads. Like if you are a father, watch the movie Old Guys on Netflix.
I'm gonna have to check that out. I keep seeing that advertised on there. Definitely we'll have to check that out. I keep meaning to. NHL for me. Very cool to see Tuesday that the ESPN did Frozen Frenzy on ESPN2, which was essentially Red Zone for hockey, right. But obviously you have to make some changes because hockey's a little bit faster paced. Right. It's like, oh, this guy came over the blue line. You'd be switching every 3 seconds.
You'd be switching, yeah.
But every NHL team was playing on Tuesday. I thought that was a very cool thing to do. MLB playoffs. I'm excited for the World Series. Go both teams. I hope both teams have fun. My kid asked me last night, he said, who do you want to win the World Series? And I honestly could not pick one. There's guys I like on the Diamondbacks. There's guys I like on the Rangers. Neither team is like hateable. I guess what I should say is both teams are very likable. Yeah, I had no issue saying that. I hope it's a good series. That's what I meant by, I hope both teams have fun.
Yeah. For me, as long as it wasn't the Astros, I was good.
As long as it wasn't the Astros or Yankees, I'm good.
All right. And then much respect to Mike. I won't talk bad about the Giants because I love Mike. And the Rangers are basically the guys the Dodgers couldn't afford anymore. That's basically who, like what's the Rangers team is. So yeah, it's a hard pick for me. But I'm already happy. Put it that way. Either team that wins, I'm not going to be upset. So
yep.
Both teams go out there and do it. Hope it goes game seven to the last out.
Oh, here's an interesting idea. Pick a team by logo. I got to go Diamondbacks. Diamondbacks have a better logo than the Rangers.
Yeah, they do. Because with the Rangers, it's pretty...
It's just a T, right?
Right, yeah.
Or it's a circle thing with like a baseball and a T in it.
Yeah. Like they should... Like, yeah, that's a good point. Like they should make like something with like a Texas Ranger.
Diamondbacks have like seven different uniforms. They're all fire. Like I guess I'm going
They're almost like the Oregon of... It's like the Oregon of baseball.
I like Corbin Carroll, the rookie there on the Diamondbacks too. So I guess Fabulous Disaster just helped me make up my mind. Go Diamondbacks. All right, guys. Time for the run and rundown. Thank you guys who've been watching on YouTube, Twitch, and our Facebook. It is time for us to run down some of our friends and sponsors. Make sure you guys check out the Fig Cave podcast. I'm not just saying that because Phil said yo in the chat. I say it every week. Fig Cave podcast with Phil Gentile and Nick Thompson, our good brothers over there. They should be dropping a new episode Friday as well, I assume. Conversations with Kenny. Kenny's been in the chat the whole time. Check him out. He's got a podcast on every single day. Gorilla Brain podcast, a pro wrestling podcast. And of course, don't forget to check out Wrestling Collector Shop, jjfigures.com, and on Whatnot, Homage, Seat Geek, Barrios Toys, Zombie Hideout in Springfield. Kayfabe Toys, they're doing an autograph signing with Stan Hansen. Don't forget about that. You guys can do mail-ins if you got one of them Power Town figs. So make sure you check that out as well. You guys can follow us. Everything you need is over at runinpod.com, youtube.com/therunninpodcast. Instagram is at the Runin Pod, and X, Twitter, whatever you want to call it, even though we don't use it that much, is at Runin Podcast. Also, DJ, I don't know if you saw this. There is a special person in your life in the chat. I just threw it up on the screen. Isn't that your sister?
It's D. That's Sis D. And that's nice. Her favorite wrestler. She's always going to yell Stone Cold.
Yeah, Stone Cold.
Yeah.
Stone Cold. All right, guys. This has been episode number. Oh, and DJ, throw your Twitch out there. You said if you might be playing some Miles Morales.
Spider-Man. So Fig, Spider-Man. It's Fig Knight 27. FIGHT 27.
That's right.
Decent. footage of Spider-Man 2.
All right, guys. Thank you so much for listening. Please rate, review, subscribe on Apple Podcasts, all that good stuff. Do everything you would want people to do if you had a podcast. My name's Tommy Paradise.
It's your boy DJ and Inglewood. Tommy's Inglewood.
And have a safe and happy Halloween on Tuesday, guys. Make sure you check your candy for drugs. And if you get any with drugs in it, send it to me.